TFNN. Headline news update.
Good afternoon, folks. Steve Rhodes coming to you live from the shores of Delray Beach, Florida. This is your 2 p.m. update. And currently got a bit of a mixed bag out here. The Dow's off 54 and the New York Stock Exchange is down 22. Otherwise, all the other indices are trading to the upside. The S&P's up 8. NASDAQ 100 to 112. Russell's up 2. Semis are up 10. Trannies are up 86 points. Let's go spend some time and take a look at our cash indice charts out here. As soon as that comes up on the screen on the upper left, you'll see the Dow Jones Industrial. Now, the Dow has been trading in a small consolidation pattern, and on Friday, price broke through that. So what does that give us? That gives us a measured move equal to or greater than that consolidation. So if we just simply copy it and move it up here, well, Stevie's going to have to do a couple of different things out here. He's got to use the old scrunching technology. And this would say that the Dow is going to go target the 36,115 level. Now, that's a small consolidation pattern out here. Hopefully, we'll have enough time for me to show you the larger consolidation, which is basically at the Dow's all-time high. So that's level that it's going to need to take out in order for this other consolidation to come to fruition. The S&P 500, what we've got here is an A to B equals CD to the upside. If we get a bearish reversal candle, that would confirm a Gartley sell pattern. Otherwise, price should continue higher. The same thing inside the NDX 100. With regard to the Russell 2000, she's just really inside a large consolidation pattern, so I'm not going to spend any time taking a look at that. With regard to the semis, they suggest that price should continue to move higher. This what this did was this came back and price tested its TD9 threshold level, where the bottom actually came in. That was on the trading day of back on August the 19th. That level, by the way, was tested and then rejected with lighter volume back on October 12th. So this suggests that there's an A to B equal CD that's also forming inside of the semiconductor index. Now, the transports, which have been the strongest out here, will form a TD9 count top today. Now, the cool thing about this is that if we see price close over today's high tomorrow or the next day, that tells you the transports are on fire. And maybe the transports are on fire. Maybe that's the message of getting all of the ports cleared up and so forth. But that you'll get that confirmation. You should have that in the next couple of days out there. With regard to the spot volatility, still below its 50-day exponential moving average. That's bullish for the S&P 500. The XAU did form a TD9 count top on Friday. This could suggest a pullback to its oscillator and change line. Currently printed at 124.69. Folks, stay tuned for David White, the Power Trading Hour. He's up next. Tom O'Brien will take us on home at 3 p.m. And I'll be back with you tomorrow at 1. Take care and have a great day.